The upshot of bundling the IPC and recovery management is that a service can safely collect all the breadcrumbs it left behind in all the places that it touched through the course of its service. Examples of such breadcrumbs include memory that was allocated but not reclaimed, file handles, communication handles, or orphan windows that have been created on the display. All of these are breadcrumbs that may have been left behind by failed clients or servers. And the fact that you have a transaction tree that records the trail of all the nodes that were touched and the temporary states that were created on all these nodes allows these breadcrumbs to be cleanly reclaimed. And there is no extra communication for the recovery management itself, because whatever communication is needed for the transaction managers to talk to one another in participating in the transaction that is shadowing the IPC actually rides on the IPC itself, and therefore it comes for free. And Quicksilver only provides the mechanisms. The policy is entirely up to each service, and in fact, services can simply ignore these mechanisms if they don't need any recovery management, or choose a policy that is commensurate with the type of service that it is providing. Because there's a variety of mechanisms available in the operating system, simple services may choose to use low overhead mechanisms, whereas a more involved service such as a file server may use weighty mechanisms in order to recover from failures. The overhead for recovery management in Quicksilver is very similar to what we already saw in LRVM. The transaction managers have to write log records at every one of these nodes because they are handling the interactions between clients or servers at this node with respect to other sites. The transaction managers have to write log records for recovering persistent state. Similar to LRVM, Quicksilver also uses in-memory logs for the transaction managers, and these transaction managers flush the in-memory logs that they create to record persistent states to disk periodically. How often these in-memory log records are written out to the disk by the transaction manager is a performance factor, and it is a window of vulnerability just as in LRVM. Ideally, if you want to be absolutely sure that you can recover from failures, whenever any persistent state is modified and a log record is written by the transaction manager, that log record should be committed to the storage, but that costs synchronous I/O. And so if you're worried about that, you might want to do that more opportunistically, assuming there are not going to be too many failures. So there is a performance vulnerability trade-off in how often the transaction manager writes log records to the storage device.